The US Air Force is making plans to work with Starlink to support its operations in Europe and Africa. This comes after Starlink was commended for its role in keeping Ukrainians online amid Russia's ongoing invasion. In an announcement, the service said that US Air Forces Europe, Air Forces Africa would purchase service from Starlink, which is operated by SpaceX, to support the 86th Airlift Wing based at Ramstein Air Base in Germany. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the US Air Force is purchasing Starlink services. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Starlink is a satellite internet constellation operated by SpaceX, providing satellite internet access to most of the Earth. Musk's Starlink aims to sell internet connections to almost anyone on the planet by way of a growing network of private satellites orbiting overhead. As of April 2022, Starlink consists of 2,100 mass-produced satellites. SpaceX describes the Starlink system as a high-speed, low-latency broadband internet option for users all over the world. There are plans that could see the number of satellites potentially reach 42,000 in the future. Instead of relying on fiber optic connections or 5G towers, Starlink connects users to satellites using transceivers that can be set up anywhere. Users can switch off a transceiver and take it with them. Users usually see download speeds between 100 megabits per second and 200 megabits per second and latency that can be as low as 20 milliseconds. Over 10,000 Starlink terminals are currently in use in Ukraine, and each terminal can serve many users. The 12-month, $1.92 million contract was awarded in late July and is set to begin sometime between August and July 2023. It's meant as an interim solution until a broader agreement is reached. Politico first reported on the contract after it was announced on August 4th. The intent is to provide either first-generation or high-performance satellite terminals and internet service, either static or fixed site or portable/mobile, to the terminals, enabling users to connect devices to the internet, the Air Force said in a justification document for the sole source contract. Starlink is the only company that can provide low Earth orbit satellite communications in both Europe and Africa, the document says, referring to Starlink as having the most well-established LEO satellite network with more than 1,350 satellites, while its competitors are still in their infancy. Referring to Ukraine, the document says, Starlink is also the only such network currently being used in a contested environment. The Air Force Research Laboratory has found that in contested environments, low Earth orbit satellite constellations are much more resilient to signal jamming and also provide the low latency required to support tactical missions, according to the document, which notes that the Air Force is pursuing several efforts that could require support for tactical missions in contested environments, including agile combat employment. The communication requirements within and around Eastern European areas in support of Ukraine operations expands daily, the document says. Starlink LEO fulfills the requirement of reducing processing times, and increases theater-based operations on changing requirements and locations. After extensive research, it was found that SpaceX Starlink is the only vendor able to provide this specialized communication service in the current areas of operation in the required time, the document adds. U.S. Air Force officials began researching commercial low Earth orbit internet service in Europe and Africa in June 2021. Whereas Starlink was found to be the only current provider in both regions, other firms, namely Amazon, OneWeb, and Telesat, are all expected to provide service there in the next few years, the justification document says. Ukraine's internet and communications networks were attacked in the hours before Russia launched its offensive on February 24th and have been targeted throughout the conflict. Shortly after Moscow began its attack, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk said Starlink had been activated in Ukraine in response to requests from Ukrainian officials. More than $15 million has been spent by various stakeholders to provide the hardware and transport them to Ukraine. Lots of people are using the system. Since then, Ukrainians have relied on Starlink for civilian and military communications, and Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky has praised it as very effective. U.S. military officials have also praised Starlink for its resiliency in the face of what Musk has called increased jamming and hacking attempts by Russia. Brigadier General Steve Bataw, director of the Space Portfolio at the Pentagon's Defense Innovation Unit, said the satellite network has had a strategic impact, telling Politico that it had totally destroyed Russia's information campaign. SpaceX has received a number of contracts from the U.S. military. General Stephen Townsend, who retired this month after 3 years as head of U.S. Africa Command, said at a Defense Writers Group event in July that he had seen how Starlink was being used in Ukraine and was intrigued by it. "I've asked my staff, hey, can we use that capability? And if so, tell me how," Townsend said when asked if a service like Starlink could be useful for militaries in Africa. "I don't have the answer back yet, so I don't know, but I've asked the same question you just asked." In 2020, the United States Air Force utilized Starlink in support of its advanced battlefield management system during a live fire exercise. They demonstrated Starlink connected to a variety of air and terrestrial assets, including the Boeing KC-135 Stratotanker. This clearly indicated that the system had potential for military use. Starlink's effectiveness in Ukraine has also attracted attention in China, where researchers noted that the Chinese military should develop ways to interfere with or destroy Starlink satellites in the event of a conflict. As Starlink starts receiving military contracts, it'll be interesting to see how the U.S. forces leverage its capabilities for combat. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.